I'm thrilled today to be talking to lawyer, businesswoman, former Lord Mayor of Sydney, also a recipient of an AO for her services to community. Importantly, she's a mum, a brand new grandmother, and wife of Malcolm Turnbull, Lucy Turnbull. It's great to have you on Balance.
Thank you, Deb. It's great to be here.
Gorgeous to have you in my home. Now, I want to just take you back a little bit, because I always think that the you know, our parents and who we are in our childhood obviously shapes us. But you grew up in Sydney, but I didn't realise actually that you suffered quite badly from asthma. So the next thing you know, you're boarding down at Frensham in Mittagong.
Yeah, well, there was a lot of childhood getting up to 12, but yeah.
Yeah, so at 12 is such a young age.
And yeah, well, that's some typical boarding school age.
It's, you know, 12.
Yeah, that's year 7. Yeah, yeah. I mean, some little kids even went to boarding school earlier. Like, so two great friends of mine went to school when they were boarding school when they were about 5 or 6 or something.
That's
like that.
That's tough, because you're sort of being separated from your family and you're kind of away from all that. It's pretty difficult. And also, I would have thought being down there, that's where I do get hay fever and stuff.
Well, I probably would today. My sort of, like a lot of people with allergies, they shift over time.
Yeah.
But in those days, the mountain air really sort of cured my asthma. Because in those days, I started boarding school in 1970. In those days, there was no Ventolin. So, you know, when you had an asthma attack, you were basically put into a steaming shower. You know, my mother would turn on the shower taps full blast, and I'd just sit there and steam.
Yeah.
That was about the only thing you could do.
Wow, okay.
It was quite scary. I mean, in those days, it was quite scary.
Yeah.
It still is very scary when people have asthma.
Yeah.
Little Jack had asthma in the middle of the year, and that's really
your grandson.
Scary. Yes, and it's very scary when little kids have asthma, because they go downhill so quickly.
Yeah, and also a bit of a panic because they can't breathe.
Correct. Yeah.
I just sort of wonder how that time shaped you as a person, though. That, you know, because I mean, sort of have to fend for yourself, I suppose, when you're away from family.
Yeah, well, it teaches you a sense of independence and autonomy.
Yeah.
And I guess it sort of hones your survival instincts a bit, because it's, you know, it's boarding school's great, but it's You are away from your family and your traditional links.
And your siblings.
And your siblings and, you know, what is familiar to you. But, I mean, I loved boarding school for the first 3 years. I thought it was a lot of fun. In the fourth year, I was kind of totally over it. I was happy to do 3 years. And this wasn't weekly boarding where you went home on weekends. It was what Daisy calls termly boarding.
Yeah.
So it was pretty full on, and it was great for 3 years.
So did you get to the point where you were sort of rebellious then? Because then you're sort of getting into your 15 and 16.
I really wanted to be out of the country.
Because I could never actually pitch. I sort of know you a little bit, but the rebellious side would have thought that would have started to peak a little bit then.
Yeah, I know. And because, you know, you get cheeky when you get, you know, kids are at their cheekiest when they're a little bit bored. And I was pretty bored in that last year of school. But I think that the other thing it did paradoxically is that it actually turned me into a real city person, because it was in the, well, Mittagong's not really the country, but it was out of the city, and it really taught me to love cities and to love my city, because it was home.
Yeah.